After that we will discuss state equivalence theorem. So state equivalence theorem is nothing but we can say any two states. So suppose if I take SA and SB are the two states, so these two states are equal only if their next states and outputs are equal. So what is the equation here? The two states SA and SB will be equal. That means SA equal to SB only if S of t plus 1, that means SA of t plus 1 is equal to SB of t plus 1. That means those two next states should be equal, as well as ZA equal to ZB. That means outputs also be equal. So the statement is the two states SA comma SB are equal only if their next states and as well as their outputs must be equal. So if you see the expression SA equal to SB, if and only if SA of t plus 1 equal to SB of t plus 1, in the same way ZA equal to ZB. So this is the important state equivalence theorem. It is important for short answers questions. Okay, and now we will see the next important one as your distinguishing sequence. So we will see what is meant by distinguishing sequence. And now, so for example, we will see an example. So whatever you are seeing here is nothing but one example, which is nothing but a state table. Here we are having total six present states A, B, C, D, E, and F. And these six present states consisting of x equal to 0 column, x equal to 1 column. That means the state A moves to state E when x equal to 0, and state A in the same way it moves to state D when x equal to 1. So you can analyze the functioning of all these present states, how they are moving when x equal to 0 and how they are moving with x equal to 1. Clear? So distinguishing sequence nothing but when you compare any two states, their outputs must be different. So when you compare any two states, their output must be different, then only you can say those two states are distinguishing states. So suppose if they ask you to check whether A comma, they ask you to, if they ask you to check whether A comma B states are distinguishable or not, if they ask you to check whether A comma B states are distinguishable or not. So see here, so under x equal to 0, so first you need to verify under two conditions. One is x equal to 0 condition and second one is x equal to 1 condition. Under x equal to 0, the state A is moving. See here, under x equal to 0, the state A is moving towards state E. So it is moving towards state E, rather than output is 0. In the same way, what is B condition? The state B is moving towards state F and output is 0. Same, under x equal to 0 here, I am writing it is moving towards F and output is 0. Okay, now if you verify the outputs of these two, how they are both are equal. So you cannot say them as distinguishable. Now again bring this E here and bring this F here and see the behavior here, E comma F under x equal to 0. E, see here, E under x equal to 0, it is moving towards C, C comma 0. So right here, C comma 0. In the same way F, it is moving towards again B comma 0. So B comma 0. Now again compare the outputs here, both are same. You cannot say them as distinguishable. Follow the same process. Bring this C here and bring this B here. So what is C? Functionality of x equal to 0, C, E comma 0. So you can write here E comma 0, and the same here of B, F comma 0. Again outputs are same. You cannot say them as distinguishable. So you can continue, you can continue the same process here. So by seeing the state table itself, we can have a conclusion that what is the definition of distinguishing sequence? The distinguishing sequence should be outputs as different. So when you see the x equal to 0 category, how the outputs are here? All the outputs are 0. So under x equal to 0, there is no possibility of getting the distinguishing sequence. Why? Because see here, under x equal to 0, I took one example as A comma B, and I am going on comparison here, going on comparison here. If you compare so and so, the process will be continued, but you won't get the output as different outputs. So under x equal to 0, you can say that A comma B here not, compare, I mean, what you can say it as a distinguishable. Now, whether these are distinguishable from x equal to 1 or not, we will check now. So, under x equal to 1, so what is the functionality of a? Under x equal to 1, functionality of a, d comma 1. So, d comma 1. Now, in the case of b, how it is moving? B, x equal to 1, it is moving with d comma 0. Now, if you compare the outputs, how they are outputs? How the outputs are there? Both are different outputs. So, as per the condition, states with different outputs are called as distinguishable sequence. So, you can say this under, you can say it as under x equal to 1, as the outputs are different, you can say it as, so here, within the first comparison itself, we got the different outputs. First comparison itself, we got different outputs. So, it is called one distinguishable sequence. What are these one? The number of steps you got. This is the first step, and you compare the first step itself, you got different outputs. So it is one distinguishable sequence. Suppose if the same problem, if they gave, compare a comma e states. Now how will you compare this? The same as we said that under x equal to 0, we don't find any different outputs. So if we solve this like this, it will be time waste for us. Simply can say as the all the output values are same in x equal to 0 condition, you cannot find a distinguishable sequence. So directly you can go with the x equal to 1 condition. You can go x equal to 0. If you find all the outputs are same. So it is violating the definition of distinguishable sequence. So under x equal to 0, there is no possibility here. And now, see, suppose x equal to 1, whether it is possible or not. So first, the state A, where it is moving under x equal to 1, it is moving to D, comma 1. In the same way, E, where it is moving x equal to 1 condition, state E, F, comma 1. First, same process, both consisting of common outputs. Again, bring this D here and bring this F here. And now see the functionality of D comma F in x equal to 1. D comma F. So first go with D. How D is behaving at x equal to 1? How D is behaving at x equal to 1? B comma 0. And how F is behaving at x equal to 1? C comma 0. So in the second comparison also, this is first comparison. And this is second comparison. In second comparison also, we got outputs as same. Again, go follow the same process. Bring this B here. And bring this F here. C here. Now compare B comma C operation in this table under x equal to 1. State B is moving to D comma 0 under x equal to 1. And state C is moving towards B comma 1 x equal to 1. Now you see the outputs. The third comparison, this is first comparison, this is second comparison, and this is third stage or third comparison. Now you got the outputs as different outputs, 0 and 1. So A comma E states are getting different outputs after three comparisons, 1, 2, 3. And hence you can call them as, 3 distinguishable sequences. Why this three? Why? Because this A comma E states are not getting the different outputs at starting. This is first comparison. We didn't get. Second comparison, we didn't get. And third comparison, we got. So that's why we call them as three distinguishable sequence. So remember that distinguishable sequence is nothing but any two states are distinguishable only if their outputs are different. So you need to make them different. That means you need to follow this process. You need to follow this process until the outputs are different. Okay. If the output is not being different like this, simply you can say under x equal to zero, we are not having the chance of getting a distinguishable sequence, and go for x equal to one. So you need to write that on which condition, whether x equal to zero or x equal to one, like this you need to write here, and then you have to process this method. After doing this, after how many comparisons you are getting this different outputs, you need to count. And that count you need to measure, I will mention here. In this example, A comma B, A and B are getting the different outputs at the first comparison itself. That's why I written this as one distinguishable sequence. But here, after three comparisons, I got this different outputs as 0 comma 1. That's why I written here three distinguishable sequence. In some problems, we may get for five comparisons, then you can write as five distinguishable sequence. In some, if you get eight comparisons, you write eight distinguishable sequence. So how many comparisons you got, after how many comparisons you got, that you count that steps and write that number in the place of this three. Okay, so for this example, I got three distinguishable sequence for A comma E, and A comma B is nothing but one distinguishable sequence. Okay, clear? So this will be very important for short answer, this one and the previous what I have said as a state equivalence theorem. So you need to prepare that.